Hello and welcome to your latest daily energy report. I'm Ben Lack and I'm here to bring you up to speed on the latest daily energy news.
San Francisco has been dubbed the greenest major city by the U.S. and Canada Green City Index. Vancouver, New York, Seattle, and Denver rounded out the top five. The study, which was conducted by the Economist Intelligence Unit, analyzes the environmental performance and policies of 27 major U.S. and Canadian cities. Categories analyzed included CO2 emissions, energy, land use, buildings, transport, water, waste, air quality, and environmental governance. One common trend that was found was that of the cities that achieved high rankings were the implementation of comprehensive sustainability plans that included transportation, land use, energy use, and CO2. IBM and Brazil's largest privately owned energy provider, CPFL Energia Holdings, have announced a partnership to make CPFL Energia's energy networks more efficient and resilient. The energy provider, with IBM's communications and network expertise, plans to install 25,000 smart meters. Each meter will be plugged into a network and operate as a network sensor, helping the operations center to quickly identify potential faults and other events. The automated meters will also enable technicians to perform preventative services from a remote location, thus saving the company the money and hassle of sending crews out to each meter. The meters are planned to be installed by 2012. And finally, Texas A&M University has agreed to $15.1 million in performance contracts over the last year with Siemens. Since 2002, the campus has lowered its energy use by 35%, while the gross square footage increased by 18%. These performance contracts will help Texas A&M continue to lower greenhouse gas emissions, improve building comfort, and advance their sustainability goals by being able to pay for the solutions from the energy savings that each solution provides. Performance contracts are becoming a popular financing tool as ESCOs fight to acquire new businesses in a tight credit market.
That's your Daily Energy Report. To learn about these stories and more, please visit us at dailyenergyreport.com and also make sure to check out our podcast on iTunes. For the Daily Energy Report, I'm Ben Lack. Thanks for watching and have a great day.